Hi everybody, it's Christina from Pretty Distressed. In today's video, I am celebrating the fact that I hit 300,000 subscribers on YouTube this week. I'm so excited. Thank you so much for making that possible. So I wanna do the biggest giveaway that I've ever done. I'm gonna be giving away a SurfPrep sander to one lucky winner. So make sure you stick around to the end of this video for details on how to get entered. But I thought we'd have a little fun since I, you know, hit 300,000 subscribers. Let's see where I started from. So today I'm gonna be reacting to my first video series that I ever put up. It was pretty funny. I think I've learned a lot over, you know, the past few years. I put this video up in 2014. So let's just get into it. Let's just watch it together. Okay. So I started my channel 6 years ago with no intention of ever being a YouTuber. I was blogging at the time and I was blogging under Blogger, and it was really easy to just incorporate if you did a video onto your Blogger platform. So that's why I started my YouTube channel. And we're gonna take a look at my very first video today. The first project I ever did, I spanned over 5 videos because I thought that you had to have like short videos. Now I know that a whole project is a good video. So I'm actually gonna take bits and pieces from every video of that series and just kind of react to them and how I would paint a piece today. Okay, Chuck Paint Tutorial.
Hi everybody, Christina Mascari. It's Christina from prettydistressed.com. And I'm gonna do a series of vlogs for you over the next couple of weeks. I wanted to show you guys how to do a piece, take it from start to finish, instead of just doing a before and after. So I'm gonna break it up into several videos and just show you the process that I use for refinishing furniture and painting furniture with Annie Sloan chalk paint.
Okay, you know, I feel like my camera angle is pretty good. I'm recording this on a handy cam with just like an external microphone. I think the sound pretty good. I'm outside in my garage. I will note, I still say a lot. My attire here, I'm pretty appalled at. I think when I put these videos out, I would get weird messages from men saying things about me, and I can understand because I have no clothes on. I'm wearing a tank top. Things are hanging out. I need to put some clothes on. And my hair is very blonde. Those are the first two things that I have to say about that.
So the first thing I'm gonna do is clean my piece off. I actually got this piece for free. My neighbor was moving out around the corner and I saw this sitting in their driveway. Called my husband right away and we stuck it in the van and brought it down to my garage, and so that's where I'm gonna work on it today.
Still do that. Still pick up furniture off the side of the road.
I'm gonna clean this off. I'm also gonna take off the hardware because I'm not sure what I wanna do with it. If I'm gonna paint it the color of the piece or if I wanna paint it a different color or do a different metal finish. So since I'm not really sure what I want to do, I'm going to go ahead and just take that off and paint it separately and then put it back on when I'm done. So right now I'm just going to clean it off and take the hardware off. I use baby wipes to clean my stuff off because they're pretty durable and I always have a lot around because I have a little one-year-old daughter. So that's just, I just like to get all the dust off. So this piece is pretty dirty. It was probably in a kid's room.
Okay. You should definitely still clean your pieces. I do not clean my pieces with baby wipes now. I don't know where I learned this from. I don't know if it was just me being lazy or I just had an endless supply of wipes because I had a baby. And you definitely need more than a baby wipe to clean your stuff off. This is gonna help you get the dust off, but grease, polish, stuff like that, you wanna use a TSB cleaner or, you know, a degreaser, crud cutter, something like even Dawn soap is better than using baby wipes. So I have come a long way in cleaning my pieces.
Or something. So I just want to get all the dust off so that my paint's gonna adhere really well. Okay, so I have some water damage and some spills on top of this, and I just want to clean it up just a little bit before I'm painting. So I'm gonna take 100 grit sandpaper and just rough it up and then wipe it down, and then I should be ready to paint.
Oh, this is hurting. Okay, 100 grit is way too strong for scuff sanding and correction sanding like this. Now I would use a 220 there.
All that dust that I have.
Still use tack cloths. Good. Good for me. Getting the dust off. Wouldn't put my behind in a shot like this either. Again, going back to the inappropriate comments I used to get.
French linen today. which is a new color for me, so I'm excited. It's in the neutral palette. It's just kind of a darker gray. I've used Paris gray before, but this is a little darker. So I'm just gonna shake my can. And I got my paint opener. I usually paint my first coat right out of the can. And if I need to do a second coat, then I usually thin that out a little bit with water. So this one, for this first coat, I'm just going to do right out of the can. Really pretty color. And I'm using my Purdy white bristle, 100% natural white bristle brush. This is what it looks like, a stash brush, 2-inch. So I'm just gonna dip.
Okay, back when I started painting, all I used to use was Annie Sloan chalk paint. There are so many more paints out there now that you can choose from, and I think paint is a lot more accessible than it used to be. You can buy a lot of stuff online, and there are paints that do different types of things, but I used to be like a OG Annie Sloan number one super fan. It was like a really great paint to start out with. And back then, the reason I'm using this Purdy brush is because it was an inexpensive natural bristle brush. And back then, most people were only chalk painting or painting furniture with natural bristle brushes. They used to tell you you couldn't use synthetic brushes. Nobody made synthetic brushes for paint. Annie Sloan now has synthetic brushes. She even has videos out with her spraying her paint. So things have evolved over time. But back here, back in the dinosaur ages of 2014, everybody said you had to have a natural bristle brush, and I didn't want to pay, you know, $40 for the Annie Sloan brush, so I figured out how to do a dupe with this Purdy brush. Something funny that I recently found out, that natural bristle hair brushes are made out of boar tail, I think, or ox tail. So they're actually animal bristles, which I never thought of before, but someone brought up to me because that they were kosher and they couldn't use them. And I was like, that is funny that I've been using these for all these years and I didn't know until recently that they're made out of animal hair. Here I'm just kind of painting in fast forward motion. I'm not really teaching you anything, but you're seeing that the paint goes on without sanding or stripping.
Okay, so that's nice. I've got my main piece, and so I have removed all the hardware from my drawers, and I'm gonna paint my drawers separately. And again, all you really wanna do on this first coat is make sure that you don't have any really big gloppy splotches or drip marks. So while it's still wet like this, you just want to make sure that you don't have any of those big brush strokes or drips. And you also want to make sure sometimes your brush can shed into your paint, onto your piece. So just watch out for that. All you can do is just pluck it out and then make sure you go back over that spot, because it'll smudge it and take some of the paint off.
Still good advice. Got some airplanes and some birds in the background.
So I want to make sure I like
the lighting's pretty good though. I'm not mad at the lighting
because I can get down in these crevices. So I just kind of
natural lighting is always your best friend.
Blot it down in there, so I'm covering everything, and then I smooth back over it. You will have brush strokes, but again, that's fine because with this paint, the technique you're going for is like a hand painted look. So it's not going to look dipped. It's going to look like someone actually sat there and painted it by hand, and that's what you want.
Again, valid point. Yes, this is gonna look hand painted because of the type of brush I'm looking, the type of brush that I'm using. Nowadays, a lot of people do like a dipped look. A lot of people do like a factory finish type of look, really smooth. People, like I said, are using synthetic brushes, using a lot more water to smooth out their paint, using rollers, and even using sprayers a lot. So things have changed in the community, which I'm kind of glad for. We don't all have to paint the same way.
Okay, so I have completed my first coat on my dresser as well as my drawers. and I'm still seeing some wood peeking through there. I'm gonna show you that. So I am gonna do a second coat on this piece. So in my next video, I'll come back and show you how to do a second coat.
My Midwestern accent is strong in this video.
For more furniture painting tips, as well as other home decor ideas. I'll see you guys soon.
You can tell uncomfortable I am in front of the camera, and I feel like I'm not using my real voice. I'm kind of putting on a little bit, so that's kind of funny. Okay, I'm gonna jump to the last video in this series. There are 5 videos, and that one was the one that was most popular and kind of the first video that made me think, maybe I can do YouTube full time. So this one has like 750,000 views, and it was made shortly after that first one. So this one's all about dark waxing. I used to dark wax and wax every single piece that I used to do.
Hi everybody, it's Christina from prettydistressed.com, and I am back with my last video in my painting a piece vlog. So at this point we have prepped our piece.
Okay, I keep saying vlog, and I guess I didn't know what a vlog was. I just thought if you did a video and put it in a blog, then it was a vlog. But a vlog is more like a first person kind of holding the camera as a selfie and taking somebody through something. This is a tutorial. So again, I didn't understand YouTube speak back then.
A wet clear wax. So what I'm gonna do, I have my clear wax here, my Anisone clear wax, and I'm gonna put just a little bit of that on my paper plate.
Still agree with this. If I'm gonna use dark wax, I like to put it over a wet clear wax. And I like to clear wax my entire piece before I do distressing, shading type of waxing.
To work with this dark wax, this is the Anisone dark wax, and that's what it looks like. So I'm gonna be putting this on my piece. So I like to first have my piece wet.
I still like to cut my dark wax because I can control it better.
A little bit of the clear wax. So I'm gonna take a different spoon. I use different spoons for clear wax and dark wax because you don't want to get any of your dark wax in your clear wax or you'll kind of contaminate it. So you just want to keep them separately. Keep them separate. And I also use a separate brush for my dark wax. So I have a wax brush devoted to my clear wax, and then this is my dark wax one, and it's a little bit smaller, but
still agree with this. I still don't like to mix my wax brushes, but you can. I know how to clean them a lot better. Just if you have the right soap to clean it, a lye soap or grease cutting soap, you can get them really clean.
Done with these, I clean them with Murphy's oil soap. It cleans
don't do
well,
that anymore.
It.
Don't do that.
You can also use lye soap now. I've never used that.
Murphy's oil is probably fine, but I don't know where I learned that from either. Okay, so I stopped doing that.
I have my clear and dark wax on my paper plate. And I'm just gonna take my spoon.
I still do this. I still mix my dark wax.
Mix them and blend them. What I'm ready to do my dark wax is some fine steel wool. You find this in the section at the.
I still like to do it this way because I learned how to do it this way. The fine steel wool does make a little bit of a mess. You could probably get the same effect by just using a rag and wiping. But again, this is the way that I learned, so I still like to do it this way, whether it's right or wrong.
This part is very intimidating. I get a little scared every time I'm doing it. But again, you just want to get a little bit of wax on here, and I'm gonna really rub it into my brush.
I'm really enjoying this like really thin headband too.
Get my steel wool ready. And at this, I'm just gonna not cover the entire piece, but just go over my spots where I have distressed.
My titles dropping in are awesome. This was all edited on iMovie. I taught myself how to edit. I think I've gotten a little bit better over the years.
Really well. And then I'm going to take my steel wool over that and kind of get any globs that I see and just rub it in.
This is the same technique that I still do for dark wax. I just don't dark wax that much anymore.
You'll go back over and buff and just kind of wipe those off after you're done.
Okay, I do have to talk about the hardware. Back when I was first starting out, I rarely ever bought new hardware for my pieces. I always tried to repurpose it or paint it. And this hardware is absolutely hideous. I can't believe I kept it. I don't understand it. Why are there knobs, like two knobs on a door? And then there's like a pull one underneath that. It's just like, it's pretty bad. I should have replaced the hardware.
Careful.
Especially since I got this piece for free.
So again, just make sure you're rubbing it in really well. And then I'm gonna go right over it. Well, it's still wet, my steel wool.
I still do this paper plate thing too, if I'm using wax.
If you do get to a point where you feel like you've put too much
Do you guys
dark
still like
wax
using dark wax? I feel like not as many people use it anymore as they used to.
Get a little bit on a cloth and just go in that spot, and the clear wax will actually lift that dark wax off if you feel like you've gone too much at some point.
One camera angle the whole time too. Like, I'm not showing anybody anything close up. But I feel like the instruction's good. Okay, here's the big reveal.
And just make sure everything was wiped in and got rid of all my residue from my steel wool. And I went ahead and finished the mirror off and put the mirror on. So now you're looking at the completed piece. So it is done and ready to be sold at my garage sale.
That mirror is hideous. And I actually, I think this is the first piece that I ever sold. All the other pieces I had done were for myself or commission up to that point, and this was the first piece that I sold. I tried to sell it in a garage sale, but then I ended up, I think, selling it on Craigslist, and I want to say that I sold it for $200, and since I got it for free, I thought, oh my gosh, that's amazing. I've never made so much money in my whole life. I did sell her the mirror with it, but she didn't use it. I just gave it to her separate. I don't know why I put this on there. It looks so like 70s to me. Again, I'm still confused about the hardware, but you know, this was the first piece that I ever sold, and it turned pretty distressed into what it is. So it's kind of cool to watch this.
I'm gonna let this sit for like the next 3 or 4 days to make sure that the wax really cures before I put anything on it. And then I'll probably stage a little photo shoot and put this up on the blog for you guys.
Still recommend
see.
Doing that so before you try to sell a piece, but probably for like a week.
Painting and waxing furniture. And remember to check out prettydistressed.com for more tips on furniture painting, as well as see some of my work and for home decor ideas. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.
Such a little salesperson. I remember this video had a thing at the end where I did show like a before and an after, and I had music and stuff. But when I went to eventually monetize this video, I cut that back part off because I had used like a popular song that I did not have the rights to use. And so there was like a before and after, but I cut it out. So that would be like my only critique now, is that you can't even really tell what the piece looks like. It's far away, it's dark. But I feel like there's good information in there, you know? So that is just me critiquing and reviewing myself today. It's really fun to look back and see how much my style in videoing has changed, how much my style in painting has changed, how much has changed in the industry since I started painting. Like I said, everybody kind of painted this way when I started painting. Everything was distressed, dark waxing, texture, and there's so many different types of finishes now. I still really enjoy this finish, but just everybody's just doing so much stuff. There's boho, there's all this MCM stuff, there's people who spray, there's people who still like to hand brush, there's people that can get a smooth finish with hand brushing. There's transfers, so much stuff that I've learned in the past, what is this, 7 years? That's crazy. When I first started painting furniture, everybody's like, this is such a fad. Like, everybody's gonna hate it in a few years. And it just seems to keep growing and growing and growing. And it's really fun to look back and see where it started and know that I'm an accidental YouTuber and how much I love it today and how much I love all the furniture painters that are coming up and that I'm seeing on YouTube. I'm just so inspired by everybody. And they just really pushed me to do better and to make better videos and to paint better projects. So just super grateful that I have a channel and that you guys come and watch it. So thanks for going down memory lane with me today. Don't worry, I'm not gonna be bringing back tank tops and my running shorts anytime soon. Okay, let's get to why you're here. You wanna win that SurfPrep Electric Ray 3x4 sanding system. It comes with the sander and a bunch of the foam abrasives so you can test them out and see which ones you like best. It also is gonna have a shop vac hookup, so you can hook it up to your shop vac. The hose and stuff you're gonna have to buy separately, but I'll put all those details down in the description box. Check that out. So here's how you get entered. Make sure you're subscribed to this channel, Christina Mascari. I already know that you are. Comment down below, and then the last thing I need you to do is head on over to prettydistressed.com and sign up for my newsletter. I'll be picking a winner in 2 weeks, so get entered, and I'll be notifying you by email, so make sure that you sign up for that newsletter, because that's how I'm gonna contact you. Oh, such a good giveaway. I'm so excited about it. You guys, thank you, thank you, thank you again to everyone who has subscribed to this channel. It's just amazing. It's amazing to see how far it's come. I hope you had fun watching my first videos with me, and I hope it inspires you that, you know, you can really start from nowhere and build something. It's possible for anyone. So if you want to start a YouTube channel, man, go for it. Just put that first video up, because it'll be entertaining in a few years, if anything else. I will be back with another project soon. Thanks for being here, you guys, and I will see you next time.